الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. يقول الحق تبارك وتعالى وهو أصدق القائلين: وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. الحمد لله. Dear brothers, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are in a blessed day of Friday. Alhamdulillah, to have reached up to Friday's ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To have woken up healthy, happy, comfortable is big ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many people tonight, they went to sleep, they did not manage to wake up. Every single day, when you wake up, the first thing, according to the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the first thing you should do when you wake up is to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who's given you life after taking your life. Alhamdulillah alladhi ahyani ba'dama amatani wa ilayhi an-nushur. Therefore, dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have not created the jinns or the humankinds except to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is one of the main reason, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken a responsibility for the rizq. He said, مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken a responsibility for our rizq. Therefore, we shouldn't be making excuses of not obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not attending our salat on time, or doing anything that we've been commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because I am busy with work, because I am busy with this, busy with that. That is not the purpose of your creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought you in this life with purpose. If you do not have purpose, you will become like a big television that does not work. It is purposeless. What do you tend to do? The first thing that comes to your mind, if you have a big TV, it does not work. The engineer comes and tells you that it does not work. Are you going to keep it just for the beauty of the sitting room? No. The first thing you will do is throw it away. If you have a beautiful fridge, very big, and you're told that this is not repairable, because it is, does not fulfill the purpose of what you should do. Therefore, what do you think to do is get rid of it. Therefore, my dear brothers, if we are in this life and you do not understand your purpose, is like traveling and not knowing where you're going. If somebody sees you, you're in the car and you're traveling and you're just going, somebody stops you. Where are you going? I do not know. I am just going. Know that life is very short. Know that even if you're traveling, the car has limited petrol. Therefore, you have limited time to live in this life. Do not live a life that does not have purpose. If you go to Asda, you have a purpose. You know that I want to buy that thing. If you go to petrol station, you know that you are going for petrol. Therefore, the purpose why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has differentiated you between yourself and animals, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you intellect, aql. Therefore, he's differentiated you between them and the human being, and he's commanded you to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a short period of time. This ibadah is not eternal. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was interested with ibadah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have told us that in Jannah also we'll have to pray, in Jannah also we'll have to recite the Quran, in Jannah also we have to fast. No, it is short period of time. Once you pass this test, that's it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment, he said, فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ. For those Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give them the book of deed with the right hand. فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ. وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِشِمَالِهِ فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٍ. If you pass, there's a comfort waiting for you. If you fail, there's a punishment that is waiting for you. Therefore, my dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the main purpose of bringing you to this life and taking responsibility for feeding you is ibadah. The ulama, they came to explain what is ibadah. They said, كل ما يحب الله ويرضاه. Anything that you do that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ibadah. Going to work with an intention to feed my family so that I do not steal, I do not take haram, I do not beg. Therefore, that is ibadah automatically. Doing adhkar, كل ما يحبه الله ويرضاه من الأقوال والأفعال. Either something that you're saying, I'm reminding somebody of salat, I am talking to people to remind them of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything that you do that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is ibadah. Looking after your children, talking to your children, advising your family, and all these becomes ibadah. Anything that you do, going to work, going to university, going to the doctors, I am going to the doctor because I am not well, I'm going there to become healthy, to get medication, to become healthy, that becomes ibadah. Because when I'm healthy, I can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am going to the doctor because my eyes cannot see properly. I am going to get eye drops. Once I get the eye drop, I can recite the Quran. I am very comfortable. Anything that you do that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it becomes ibadah. Therefore, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us, my dear brothers, from the minute we wake up until the minute we sleep, there are things that we could do that becomes ibadah. Even going to the toilet, my dear brothers, becomes ibadah. I am going to the toilet to shower so that I go to the masjid, I have wudu, that I am clean to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in tahara. Therefore, that becomes ibadah. I am going according to the sunnah in the toilet. I am sleeping according to the sunnah. I am thanking Allah when I wake up according to the sunnah. I am wearing these clothes according to the sunnah. Therefore, everything that you do, my dear brothers, becomes ibadah. Depending on your intention. I am going to college, inshallah, once I qualify, I will help. I will feed my family halal. I will help the needy. All your life becomes ibadah. Therefore, my dear brothers, the most important thing is to do what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Min qawlin wa fi'lin. Whatever you do, ask yourself, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to be happy? Continue. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to be happy, then the brothers, you do not have time to waste. Therefore, amongst the targets or among the purpose why people or target people set themselves in this life, there are those who set themselves target to be a millionaire. Whether it is halal, whether it is haram, whether it is through selling drugs, whether it's through stealing, whether it is through riba, I want it and I want to get it. His target, he will wake up day and night, I want to work, I want to go to university, I want to do this, I want to do that. His target is to be a millionaire, to have money. He has no any other target, no thinking about studying, praying, worshipping Allah, or anything else. As long as I get money, I am happy. He set his target from very young age. And there are others, and those people are their brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, said Allah yabsutu rizqa liman yasha'u wa yaqdir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will only give you what he wants to give you. If you steal, if you cheat, if you sell drugs, what only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to give you, other than that, you're just taking sins. You are not getting any extra out of your intellect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yabsutu rizqa liman yasha'u wa yaqdir. For those he wants, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them in abundance. For those he doesn't, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them little. Therefore, my dear brothers, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you little, the ulama, they said, this wealth, this money is like medicine. Sometimes you just need little bit to get better. If you need 2 tablets to get better, it is no good giving you 10, will kill you. Therefore, they say, this money, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of your body, knows how much you need to survive and live a comfortable life. Therefore, if he gives you little, he knows your body needs this much to survive. And if he give you much, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows there are those whose test is to have so much, see you what you will do with it. And there's those who have little, see you what you will do with it. Those who have little, patience is required. And those who have a lot, shukr is required. A lot of them, my dear brothers, sometimes Allah will give you money, you will end up not paying zakat, you will end up cheating and using that money in involving riba and all others and everything. That money that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you becomes the reason for you to go to Jahannam. Therefore, my dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَفَرِحُوا بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Those people who have set themselves target to just get little of this wealth, of this dunya. وَفَرِحُوا بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا مَتَاعٌ. They're so happy to gather the dunya. In comparison to akhirah, this is almost nothing. Therefore, dear brothers, there are others who set themselves target to become famous, to become presidents, to become kings. It does not matter, killing, stealing, doing this, doing that, whatever it takes, my target is to reach, to be a footballer, to be an actor, to be this, to be that, to be a president. That is the target until they achieve that target. In between, they do not have plans of praying, they do not have plans of reciting the Quran, they do not have plans, as long, whatever it takes. And there are others, the brothers, who do not have any targets. They just sleep like an animal. Eat, sleep, eat every single day. All they're waiting is for death to come. That's it. Just like an animal. An animal eats and sleeps and have children. Similarly, all they have is eat, wake up in the morning, eat, go to work, come to sleep, and then sleep, tomorrow goes again and everything, until the day death comes. You're just making numbers. قَدْ عَاشَ قَوْمٌ وَهُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ أَمْوَاتُ. Imam Shafi'i, he said, there are people who are living amongst the people, but they are dead. They're just waiting for their day to come. They are neither benefiting themselves or benefiting others. And there are others, my dear brothers, for those kind of people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَنَا وَرَضُوا بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَاطْمَأَنُّوا بِهَا وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ آيَاتِنَا لَغَافِلُونَ. Those kind of people who have no targets, who have no purpose in this life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أُولَٰئِكَ مَأْوَاهُمُ النَّارِ. They will come, they've wasted their life, and they will come, a place of Jahannam has been prepared for them. The last one, dear brothers, they are those who set themselves target of ridallahi wal jannah, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at any cost, whether it is to give my money, whether it is to give my life, whether it is to give anything and everything, dear brothers, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to get Jannatul Firdaus. Therefore, that is the kind of life why you should live, dear brothers. A short life that you have to earn the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever you have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, He said, وَبَتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ. Whatever you have, if you are a doctor, use it to build the akhirah. If you have money, use it to build the akhirah. If you have children, teach them to build the akhirah. Whatever you have, use it to build the akhirah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dear brothers, our creator, He said, بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. You tend to prioritize dunya while akhirah is eternal, is forever. Therefore, my dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet ﷺ to tell us, قُلْ, tell them, ya Muhammad, these four things, very important. إِنَّ صَلَاتِ, all the salat that I am praying. وَنُسُكِ, all the ibadas that I am worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَحْيَايَ, my life from the minute I wake up until I sleep, from the minute I am born until I depart this dunya. وَمَمَاتِ, my death, لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands me, and I will stop what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden me. Therefore, if you live that life, my dear brothers, living for Allah, doing for Allah, giving for Allah, stopping doing something because of Allah, Allah, you'll enjoy this life and the life after here. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us. وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ سَيِّدِنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَىٰ آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ وَسَلَّمَ.